Hi guys, it's Heather here at the Craft Shack, and I'm not going to do anything fast forward, speed through, or anything today. I don't even really have a project for you. Instead, today I have a walkthrough of my art journals. Not sure if you're into that sort of thing, but a lot of people have said that they'd really like to see what's in each of my books, what type of books I've used, and that sort of stuff. So I thought, well, it's Kraaft It, not so live, so maybe that's what I'll do this time. So hopefully you enjoy this. I have got a collection, as you can see here, of art journals, and they're totally out of order. I grab whichever one I want to use for whatever reason I want to use it, and I don't really fuss over it too much. And I'm going to show you, I even forgot to show you my newest one, which is the extra large mixed media from Canson. I'll show that one too, but I didn't have the dilution journals till long into this journaling process, and I tried everything. I was trying to be really cheap and everything else, but I just wanted to show you. We'll just start with the biggest ones and work our way down to the smallest ones. How about that? Like I said, they're totally out of order, so you're gonna see all kinds of things. So I'll just start with this one first. It's my most recent one, and it only has this one page done in it. But that was the Tim Holtz bird stamps. And I think I did this in a Kraaft It together with a bunch of friends last year. But that's pretty much all that I've done in that. I have put some like jelly plate pulls on there too, but they're not really for journaling. I think I ripped them out actually. But and then I had read somewhere where people were using old books, and I have lots of these old journal or atlases that are totally out of date, and actually the library threw them out. And because the library threw them out, I figured might as well use them for something. And sometimes I rip the pages out and use the maps in other places, but this was one of the very first attempts I ever had at art journaling, and was trying to use different techniques and new modeling paste that was not really modeling paste. It was more like compound, joint compound. Tried to do the doll thing. Found out real quick what isn't my style. That's as much as I've learned on that. But that was just the inside cover. Then I did this. I was so proud of this. So this is actually one of my favorite songs, Speak Life from Toby Mac, and I used that as the inspiration for all these wonderful words, the life that you speak to people and what it makes it grow, makes each of us grow, and joy falls like rain. Use your words to inspire. I thought this was great. So this was early on. I had learned by watching many videos, you know, the shadowing techniques and stuff. So like I said, very beginnings of art journaling. It's cute. I like it, but it's huge. It's huge. So there's only one other page in this book, and that was this one that I did. And I think there's a video on this one, but I did this to represent my crafters community all over the world with these wonderful mushroom houses that came from Tina Van Eyck had carved this stamp, and I just had to use it. I wanted as much dimension as I possibly could, and it's very dimensional, but it still works in this big book. So, I mean, this is a wood, one of them wooden cutouts. But, I mean, look at this stamp that she did, and oh, there's texture and embossing powder. Yeah, I did everything I possibly could throw at this thing. So, that's it for that book. Like I said, they're not one of my journals is full, not one, which is totally fine. I was worried that doing a journal walkthrough and not having a complete journal was going to be a problem, but hopefully you don't mind. So now we're into the large dilution journal, and I started this with the Word of Inspiration Wednesday. We were on frost, and I decided to draw something, and I only had colored pencils with me at the time, and so I played with layering colored pencils and just trying to get rid of the blank page is what I was trying to do in this journal. It was so perfect and pristine and not used, and I just wanted to dirty up the pages, really. So then I did an experimenting page where I was trying to figure out how to do different washes and glazes and things like that. And I actually thought that I would do all of my pages this way, where I'm practicing or testing. Can you see that? Some of the words are basically saying how I made this look this way, or what I used to do this here. So I can go back and look, you know, that I had put black gesso through a stencil, and then I used pit pens to make the connection. So that's her. That was done with gesso. And anyway, just different glazes that I mixed and so on. And then this page is one of the times where I had just said, forget everything that you've learned or you've tried to learn by watching others, and just do something that works for you. And this is called Breaking Free. And I did this in January of last year, just over a year ago. And there is a video on this one, so if you're curious how I made it. But the whole point to it was to let go and to break free. And I think I did that. I did it successfully. And every page from here on out, I feel very good about. Now, this is before one of the other journals, three of the other journals. So you'll see me go back to trying to learn, trying to be likes, trying to be, you know, emulate some other people. But here's where I actually broke free and did me. This is me on this page. And each of these, I talk about this in the video, but each of these is a map from all over the world. And these are spheres juggling up in the air. And basically, it's everything that I get to encompass being a part of the Crafters community, the Craft Shack, and what the Craft Shack does, and all these people that I get to meet, and all the different jobs I have, and keeping everything cohesive. And it's all represented in that book. It's kind of cool. This is also, there's a video on this one as well, and this was me trying to experiment some techniques that I wanted to use in a larger painting that I've still yet to finish because I just couldn't, I can't get the technique down of what I want it to be. But I was transforming during this process, and so did this flower. And if you saw that video, then you know all about that. So I'll do my best to put links in the description of each of these if there's a video for them. I'm going to try. Anyway, this was a Kraaft It Together, and I used an underpainting that had been sprayed on, and then did some glazing over it, and learned a lot about glazing in this. I just received Dina Wakely's glazing medium, so that was fun. I really like this page. Never know if you can see very well, but we'll zoom in a little bit better. I think that will help. Okay. I liked it. I mean, it's rustic looking, but it has bright colors. It's got sparkles, which you can't go wrong with sparkles. My grandmother, I was showing my grandmother this, and she laughed. She went, well, I don't get it, but it looks okay to me. But yeah, I glued underpainting on that, or under paper on that. So I'm at grandma's, and I was totally bored out of my mind, and I just sat and doodled while we watched something. I don't remember what it was we were watching, but this gets me through things, being able to doodle. I haven't done anything with it. I made gesso over it. I don't know. I was just free flow doodling. This was testing. What was this testing? I think this was ink tents. I think these were ink tents blocks, I want to say. They are totally permanent. I have tried to move them since, and they are totally permanent. And that actually I think is really pretty. It's totally incomplete, but it's like a test. I was just testing to see. I was actually cleaning off my brush, and it turned into a swirl, and then next thing I know, I'm testing to see if these flowers will move after it's dry. And now I've got this page that's kind of half done, but someday, who knows. This is, you'll see this throughout all of my journals. I just grab something and do a wipe off. It might be my brush, it might be my sponge, it might be, in this case, it was a yellow sponge covered in yellow paint. And then I did crackle paste through a stencil that had stuff on it, and I was just finding anything I could to put it on. I had doodled this dragonfly as a test for something else that I was doing, and I didn't like where it was going, so I just stopped. So this is going to be a background for something someday. I like this. I like this modeling in here and the crackles that you can see. And then this is just like regular paste. Doesn't even seem like it's crackled, but it is crackle paste. And there's some crackles down here too. But this was the Love Summer Art. There is a video on this one as well. I did this when I was on vacation last summer in Arizona, and that was fun. Ruby watched me do it. She videotaped it, I mean. And then Carly woke up while we were in the middle of it, and she sat on my lap and helped me, and she colored some of the green that you see here. So that was fun. Nice little moment with the grandbaby on my lap. So, and then she and I played around with stamps, and she's like, I want to play grandma. So, you know, I just let her have her own page, and I would color while she, because you can't just give her stuff and let her be. She's like, do it with me. So I sat and drew flowers, and she stamped all over my page, and then she colored, and I may or may not cover that up. I don't know. It's Carly's art journal page, so maybe I won't cover it up. There's a video for this, Kraaft It Live video, so it's a long one, but yeah, this was a moon that I cut from that gigantic Atlas book, and I saved it for this piece. Took me over a year to almost 2 years to actually complete. Just needed to learn more and be confident in my own abilities. This was another experiment page, and then I turned it into something, and I think the quote says it all. Just a little mayhem to control the chaos. I had gotten pan pastels, and I wanted to see how they worked on texture. So this is soft. What is this called? Light molding paste, light modeling paste through a stencil. And then I went over it with pan pastels to get that shading that you see. I wanted it to look wavy. I think I did that. It's a leaf pattern, but I made it look this way, I think. I don't know. It looks that way to me. And then how do they react with like acrylic paint and, you know, all kinds of stuff on here. I just wanted to see how it would work. And then I sprayed it to see how permanent it is. And I mean, it doesn't come off at all. It's quite nice. It does have kind of a plasticky sheen to it. That's the protectant sealant stuff. This, I think, was a Kraaft It Together one Saturday hangout with the gang. Oh, okay, this is my most recent editions. I have actually four pages in here that are just brand new today. So while I've been on hiatus and not doing much other than sitting in my bed, I have been drawing, I have been coloring, I have been experimenting with things, and I did these two pages on watercolor paper. This one here is done with Neo Colors. This one here is done with Portfolio, the oil pastel that is water soluble. And then today I put them, this is just black gesso, and glued it over the top of that so it would pop, because those bright colors, I thought that would be really good. And then this is pan pastel in the back that has not been sealed until I glued this piece on, and I actually went over it with the gel medium that I glued it in on. So it is sealed now, but it wasn't sealed the way you would normally seal. It's just sealed with the glue that was underneath. On top of these, because they are water soluble, I did not put any medium on, just under. So that's those. And the images came from my Patreon site for January. This was the first sketch, and this is the bonus sketch. So if you're a Patreon, you already have this sketch for sure, and if you're at a certain level, then you have access to that one as well. Again, another wipe off page. That's going to turn into something cool at some point. I don't know. You have a stencil, it has stuff on it. You got to put it somewhere. So, there is a video on this one. It's also a Kraaft It Live, so this one's a long one as well. But it's my little bear. He's peeking up over the branch. And this was done in Twinkling H2Os in Arizona with Sylvia manning the camera. That was a lot of fun. It took me quite a while to get all that texture. I did do that part off air. I didn't complete him in the 1 hour show, of course, but yeah, that was lots of fun. That was, I think, October of last year, 2015. So he's a lot of fun. I call this page Mama. Like, he's yelling help. He got stuck in the tree. Can't get down. Okay, this was in response to all of the ick that was going on when the terrorist attacks happened to Paris, and there were several other areas of the world that were under attack and experiencing some terrible things. So I actually was sick that day for a couple days, and when tragedy strikes, what do you do? So I begged my family to bring me some of my supplies up, and I sat on the couch and did this with mostly my fingers. There wasn't really a brush or anything involved. It was mostly my fingers adding gesso to the page, and then Neo colors are all the color that you see, and the Stabilo all pencil for the black lines that I sketched everything on. But yeah. Another one of those Patreon moments. I was testing, these are two different papers, and I don't know if you can see that. This one's whiter, this one's yellower. Not all dilution books are like this, I guess, now, but they used to be. Every so many pages is another type of paper. So there's this paper and this paper. And so here's a page where a spread where there's one type on one side and one type on the other side. And I wanted to see how the elegant writer would react on either of these papers if it made a difference. And I drew these images, just free-handed these images. And when I saw them, I thought, ooh, that's kind of fun. So I used those as the sketch for that month for Patreon. And they got the line art without the drippage and all that. And then I went ahead and colored, or not colored, but got activated it with the water and then let it drip. And it didn't move like it would on watercolor paper, but it still was interesting. I think that's cool. I don't know that I'll ever do anything to this page, because if I add water to this, this will also bleed. None of this has been activated, so it could be activated with water right now, and I don't know that I want to do that. I think I want to leave them just as is. There are blank pages every so often, and then there's a masterpiece. This is the New Year's Eve hangout that we did, which was one of my most favorite things ever in my entire career. To get to hang out with people all over the world for hours and hours was just so much fun. To have a really good time with Cece, the planning of it, the hanging out together to come up with the different things we're going to do. And we really didn't plan activities per se, but we had a couple of special guests that we worked on, and that was fun. But then to be able to do something, this is my very first cityscape, so this was really... I'm really proud of this, because I just made a cityscape, and it was like art journal bingo we did, where people called out colors and told us what to do, and then we turned it into this. So lots of fun. Lots of people played along with this, actually, and I'm going to put a hashtag, if I can find it, put a hashtag on. Here it is. So here's a hashtag. If you go to Instagram and search this hashtag, you will find a ton of people who played along that night. And it was so much fun. It really was so much fun. So you should check that out. There's lots and lots of cool stuff there. But my little satellites up on top of my buildings. I love them. I love all of this. So it's just so cool. That was just so much fun. I can't stop looking at it. The colors are awesome. I can't believe I like pink and orange together, but I do. And then a little bit of blue thrown in. Bam. That just, ugh. Anyway, okay, moving on. So now here's some pages to be played with. So this has like the stenciling through here was modeling paste. And then what do I do with it? I went over here and wiped it off. So, and same with my credit card thingy had some paint on it. So I wiped it off, you know. And then here's the second page I did that night of the New Year's Eve party. And this is actually a napkin. This rectangle that you can kind of see in there is a napkin. Or, you know what I learned recently? You over there on the across the pond, you guys call these serviettes, I think. I may have said that totally wrong, but yeah. So napkin or the serviette. Anyway, glued that down and then continued the flowers in. I think that's ink tint, so it would be permanent because I wasn't sure exactly what I was going to do with it. Yeah, I don't remember. There was some alcohol involved with that evening, so I don't really fully remember. Okay, so this I just did today. This I just did today, both of these. Now this one on the right is a watercolor. The background is absorbent ground. I gessoed the pages, and then I put absorbent ground on top of that, let all that dry, both coats. Did not let this dry long enough before I closed the book, obviously, because it's transferred over to this page, but whatever, we'll leave that go. And then I used my Kiritake Ganzai water, what are they called? Tombi watercolors, and did the background and all that. This image is from Cece's Patreon. So if you are a Patreon for Cece or you want to be, these are types of things that you get free from her for being a Patreon, but her little sketch. And I put him in the book. So I like it. Oh, and then I doodled around the edge, of course, because I have to do that. And this over here was me just trying to make the paint dance on the book like I've seen it done in other videos, specifically one that Cece had done, and I just couldn't get it to do what she got it to do, but I like the drips and I like where it's going. I think this is going to be flowers at some point. Shoot, if I close this book again, maybe they'll just transfer over to it, but... Anyway, here's another one of those moments where I let Carly have at it. She told me to make her a rainbow, so I made a rainbow over here and she played with the rest. It's also a place where I've wiped off. I have some stenciling going on here and there, so eventually this one's going to become a journal page, and it will be one of those collaborative journal pages. I may even have her help me paint it. You don't know. I think I did this one on Kraaft It Live as well, big doilies, and these were some jelly plated leaves that I cut out and put on it. I don't know that I love this page. I was just really wanting to explore products and see what happens to things. I love this glittery, shimmery green. That's all magicals and yeah. I overdo the doodling sometimes. I think that's just totally out of place, but so what? I mean, it's a part of the journal page, so leave it go. Okay, now, these two pages are just total wipe-off pages. Like, I had extra stuff. What am I going to do with it? And I put down... I have to zoom in because this is very, very shimmery. Oh, it's as zoomed in as it'll go. All right, we're getting the camera closer then. Sorry if that's making noise and all that kind of ruckus. Okay, so let me get it to where you can see this stuff really good. Okay, so this side over here is all crackle pasty. You can see the crackle paste here and there. There, that's good. You can see the crackle paste. Okay, so I put the crackle paste through the stencil and I was cleaning it off. That's all I was doing. And then I made these ATCs using... Finnebert's mica powders and soft gloss gel. Okay, so I had these mixtures and I had little bits left over. Well, what am I going to do with them? So I came over to the wipe off page and I just spread them on. And I love this so much. Like, the colors are amazing and I love the randomness of it. That's beautiful gold. It's so rich, but all of it is so shimmery because it's those mica powders. I just love this page. I don't even want to cover it up. I want it like, maybe I'll put a quote in black or something, but I'd had so much of it that I didn't know what to do. So let me show you this page and hopefully the glare, we can calm the glare down. Yeah, like that. Okay. So I had put on the background, Harlequin stencil, whatever. And the crackle paste wasn't very thick over here. It's almost impossible to really tell there's any crackle paste at all. Every once in a while you see a little Harlequin shape or something. But I just had a lot of that green, so I swiped all that green on there. And then And then I came back with the pink, and I had swiped some of the pink over here and realized, you know what I think I want to do is make these flowers. And so I just went with my finger and just dabbed these little circles like this all over the place, and then cleaned off my fingers over here. And then the gold I just put in there is like little, these are leaves in my mind. I may someday take a pen and draw some sketchy stems in here and maybe connect some details or whatever, but I may just leave it though. I really like it. I just love how random it is, and it's so shimmery. I wish you could see it in person, because this green is that color when you stand it up like this, but then when it's like this, it's that light minty green. But of course the light's reflecting too much for you to really see it and enjoy it, but oh my gosh, it's beautiful. All right, let's go back and see. Okay. But yeah, I love this page. It might need a quote, or it might not. I don't care. Another wipe-off page. This is kind of gross looking. I was testing some combinations of products, and you can see how grainy it is. It's not pretty. So this was just basically getting rid of the product that was in the jar or on the stencil or whatever. Okay, so this was a test part of the medallion piece that I did, and I have a plan to do something with this piece. I love it. I think it's amazing, but I think I want to complete it. So that's my next endeavor. You may have seen the poppies on a napkin piece that I did earlier this month as one of the not-so-lives. This was my wipe-off page for that. So you can see where it's going, probably. I just took the palette knife and just sort of spread stuff out and went, oh, look, that kind of looks like a stem, and that looks like a leaf now. Let's put another leaf. Okay, how about that? And then I drew in it because I was trying to practice something for, like, the best way to get marks and stuff in that particular product. It was not easy, but, yeah, that's going to be fun. So that's the last page in this book at the moment. Oh, this is going to be a long one. Okay. All right. So let's quickly go through these other books that are, there's not much left, honestly. I'll try not to talk as much. So this is a composition book. I thought in the beginning of art journaling, I'll just be cheap and I'll buy composition books and I'll glue the pages together. I did a video on this. It's one of my first public art journal pages. That was February of 2014. So there's so many things I don't like about it, but you know what? It was a growing process, and I learn every time I look at this, I learn, oh yeah, that's right. I learned not to ever do that again. So, this was an experiment. I was traveling and I wanted something to do while I was traveling. So I thought, well, why don't I gesso these pages in this book and take my gelatos? And I had put, this is some kind of inexpensive joint compound that's like foamy when it dries. It's much more like foam, very lightweight, whatever this junk is. I put it through the stencil, let that dry, and then I put it through the stencil again, matching everything up, so this inside piece would be like that. That I took on the road with me, and I took my gelatos, and I wanted to see how gelatos would play on the black, and I wanted to kind of test them on this stuff because I didn't know if this stuff was going to be worth using or not. So it's like the ugliest page ever, but you know, it is what it is. All right, this was another one of those tests. I'm pretty sure there's a video for this one too, but this was just trying to put dilution paint sprays, I think, as dilution sprays underneath, and then what happens when you gesso over it. Stuff. I don't know. Anyway, blah. It's just us playing on Kraaft It Live. This is another wipe off page. So I have stenciling on here and sprays and paint and all kinds of wipe off. And then from here on out, all the rest of the book is just wipe offs, over sprays, junk. Really, I don't know that I thought maybe I would rip some of these pages out and use them in collage or something, but that blue line, that's pretty. I like that. That blue line, though, is really irritating, not only because you can see it here, but when I gessoed, I had like 4 coats of gesso on this before it finally went away. So that pretty much made me think, I don't care how cheap it is, I'm not using it. So then I kind of upgraded a little bit to a journal that I got from a friend. It's a leather journal, and I thought this would be good. And at the time, I could never find a journal that didn't have lines in it anyway. So this is a ruled. It has lines. So I did this page. And again, trying to mimic, emulate, copy, be like everyone else type of a book page. There's a lot going on this page. These were jelly plate. I had just learned how to use the jelly plate thanks to Sylvia. And I had these tape poles that she had taught me to make to clean it off. And I didn't know what the heck to do with them. And she told me I could put them in an art journal. So I wanted to prove that, I guess. I don't know. Yeah. Anyway. This, I know there's a video for this. I think there's even a video for this. Yeah, there is. Oh my gosh. The description's going to have 50 links to videos. But anyway, this was fun. This is the most fun part of this whole thing. And I don't do this on camera. I did this ahead of time because I had to use glossy accents to make these guys look like rubber boots. But, yeah, it's cute, but it's, you know, it's just like everybody else I see do art journaling in this style. And that makes me bored now. Like, there's nothing about this that excites me. But when I did it, I was very happy with myself. Like, I had done exactly what I set out to do. This is an inclusion, which was part of that class. I say class, I mean episode. And it's actually an envelope, and you can put a tag in here if you want to, so you can talk about the journaling. But somebody had asked, how do you do an inclusion? So I did a show and did an inclusion and made Puddle Jumpin'. This, oh, I did a blog post on this. I don't know that I ever did a video, but I definitely did a blog post on this. And this one is called From Ugly to Beauty or something of that nature. So what's underneath this page was testing and garbage and junk. And then I turned it into this, and I really like it. I really like it. That's a handmade stamp, a hand-carved stamp that I did. And then I was mixing all these new ingredients to me, and there's shimmery glitter in here. And I just really, I liked this because I felt like for the first time ever I was doing something that was more me than it was what somebody else did. So, yeah. And I'm pretty sure that I have a blog post on that one, so I'll try to remember to link it. But again, this is another one of those extremely high maintenance type of journals, because you have to, in order to have decent pages that aren't wimpy and will hold up to all the mixed media you want to put on them, you have to glue several of them together. Well, that takes time. And as you can see, I never took the time to do that again, especially because so many of them are stuck together from the overflow of product. So that's all that's in that book. It's probably all that will ever be in that book. Unless I, you know, fill these others and just have to put more in it. So I even tried these I got at Michael's. They're like $3.99 for this. It's totally lineless. Blank page. See? Beautiful. It has a great feel to it, although it is thin. As you can see the words through that. No, maybe you can't. Can you see the words? Yeah, you can see the words through that. So it's very thin. So I decided to use it more like a journal, like, you know, to write in. And I took it to church with me. And then I got to where I had to doodle and draw. And this was before Bible journaling for me. I just hadn't made the move because, to me, Bible journaling was too advanced. I just wasn't there yet. So it's got my prayer requests in here, other prayer requests, people that were around me having troubles, or there were things. This was a good one. This was where I started to go, oh, I can do my fancy lettering. I like that one. Trying to do some different images. And then I started doing faces. This was like a challenge time in the community, and some of the gals had, you know, were interested in challenging each of us, all of us really, to just start drawing faces. And I used to draw faces, but I never really liked doing it because I didn't understand the proportions and a lot of that kind of thing. So while I was sitting in church listening to the sermon, I drew this lady, and Greg leaned over my shoulder and said, "You should keep doing more of those." That was a little seed that was planted. So there's lots of notes in here about all different kinds of things. And then I got my Inktense blocks. And when I got those Inktense blocks, I thought, you know, I have this desire to paint. This is like the sketch of the large painting. So this is like the try it out and see, what do you think? And then I did a video on canvas, me painting pears large. Very big canvas. More doodling. Okay, and this is me. This is me Bible journaling. I drew a Bible, and then I journaled, and I drew art. And I thought, oh, I don't know. I just am not comfortable with that yet. It's stuck in the book. I stayed in the book. It's all just doodling. It's just whatever comes to me as I'm seeing or hearing or whatever. Here's one that, you know, this is like a big deal, this chalkboard art, and so I did my own version. It's hard to do, though, when you don't plan it out. Like, it's all with a pen, and oops, shouldn't have put that there, but it's off-center or whatever. And then right about this time, I started following Jamie Doherty's Creating in Faith stuff, I think it was about this time. Anyway, and I had seen some of her ribbon work and different things, and so I started to kind of lean towards that, but I still couldn't do it in my Bible. Still couldn't, no. So, but I like it. This is a page I really like. And I don't have any idea what that is. Just a sketch. Okay, so I see these kinds of things in art journals all the time, and I didn't know what the heck to do. Like, how do they make them? Like, where does it begin? So I just kind of challenged myself. This wasn't done in church. This was just me playing in the book, because I like the feel of this paper. Everything's really smooth, and it just sort of glides. So these are actually my Bible journaling pencils. Like, actual journaling, like to highlight, and that's what those are. And I use them to make these funky droplet thingies. I don't know what they are, but they're cool. I like them. And that's that book. And then this one became my wipe off book. I, about the same time, decided never to do this kind of thing again. I thought, okay, my problem is I need to do these ahead of time, like glue all the pages together ahead of time. So I glued a whole bunch of these pages together. So I have all these pages ready to be played in. And this one became like the wipe off page book, where I was just going to put all this stuff in. And it's just too much work. And I don't really have it handy. Maybe if I have my brayer out, I'll use it more. But anyway. This is the most recent purchase ever, because this one, in the beginning of December, went to Seattle, and my stepfather actually purchased this. It's buffalo hide. It's so yummy. Oh, and these are cotton pages, and they're textured, handmade paper, by the way. It's so pretty. It's well textured. Oh, anyway, we were right on the Puget Sound for that whole weekend. So I had lots of scenery. So, and I got this wet, and then I tried to fix what I'd gotten wet and make it all wet, and then that bled through, because these papers are not for water. And then I did this one upside down. I do that a lot. You'll see in the next book I do it a lot. But anyway, that was a picture view out the window. So. But that's all I've done in that book. This is more like travel and sketch with pencils type of a thing. So, and I haven't traveled since that day, that whatever. Okay, so now this is the last book, and then we're done. This is my favorite journal. I love this size. It's the perfect size. It's the 5x8, and I can travel with this anywhere on the plane. I can have it right on my lap, and it's not too obtrusive. So I really like it. And almost every page in here is my favorite page. So you'll hear me say, oh, and then I love this one. It's my favorite. Okay, so She Did Dream, I had gotten the Jing stamp. I love her face. I love everything about this page. It's one of my favorite pages. I'm going to say that a whole bunch. Just trying all the techniques that I'd seen and all that. Just trying to test this stuff. But then painting her was a dream. Absolute dream. I don't know if you can see the shimmer. Her lips are very shimmery, as you can see there. But there's shimmer on the flowers. Oh, just so fun. It just looked like a dream. And you know what? This is a dream to me. Everything that I get to do in life, it's so awesome. Anyway, so I'm going to zoom in for this one. Get us closer. Yeah. So that's that page. And then, of course, because some of this stuff had kind of bled over to this a little bit, so I went with it and just kind of continued what was happening. And it truly made me happy to do this, to just let go, not worry about the overspray or the bleed through or any of that junk, and just play. And back then I used to put dates on my things, but then I stopped doing that. And I kind of wish I would have kept on, but oh well. This was a stamp, her name is Carly. And it's a Jamie Doherty stamp. And I was going to just do Jamie Doherty stamps in this book, but that doesn't last but for two pages. So, and then I continued the drawing of all of this stuff around her, just kind of spread it out and doodled. This one took me a long time to complete. I worked on it a little bit here and there for weeks and weeks and weeks. I think it took me several months actually to finish it. But yeah, there's a video for this one. No. No, I don't think there is. I think this was a test to see if I liked some of the techniques that I've been watching. And when I said, yes, I like that, then we did the video. And I actually like this page better than the one that I did for the video. This one is my favorite page. It makes me oh so happy. This one I love. And then I like this one, but it's not. I think the color challenge that month was blue and orange. And I think because it's blue and orange, and you might hear me say that in a video, not my favorite color choices. So I think I like this one better because of that. So anyway, this was me wiping off my brush. And when I did, I, you know, kind of swirled-y, and then I went, oh, this kind of looked like, you know, and I worked with that and splattered, and yeah. Didn't have my Bible journaling book with me one day, and so I used this one instead. I keep thinking I'm going to cover it up, but then I read some of the prayers that are on there, and I think, no, they still haven't been answered, so we're going to keep that open until they all do. This was another one. I had taken this to church with me, and the background had already been done. And what I saw here was this image, like in all of the background. And so I drew it and wrote out the words, I turn my back on the things of the world and turn my face to you, O Lord, which her face is away from you and I right now, which means to me that sometimes you do have to turn your back on the people around you even. So, oh, this was, there was some darkness. There was some darkness going on. So what I was showing in this, I drew the face as part of that face challenge stuff. I'm just trying to get better at the drawing of the faces. And she's so lopsided. But I really liked how lopsided she was, because it just felt to me like this side of her, I'm going to cover something up here. Let's see if I can. This side of her just looks so depressed. I mean, her hair looks greasy and oily. She's very dark. And then this side of her, her hair is fluffy and it has life, and her eyes are glistening and her skin is glowing. And it just shows in my mind what depression does physically to us. So that was her. And then after I had done all of that, I wanted to test my new silks that came. And so you'll see there's like shimmery shiny in her hair and all over the place, because that's silks. So yeah, I'd already made my statement. So moving on. Now, this happens a lot in this book. These are gorgeous backgrounds I can't touch. I just can't. I mean, this is Tim Holtz distress paint, played with water and let it just do its thing. And then I sprayed over the top. You can kind of see a coppery, that's bloom sprays that I just sprayed over the top. See that? I just couldn't. I can't. Every time I look at it, I'm like, no, not covering it up. Anyway, I did this. I did a few of these pages. You might hear this a few times. Traveling different times. So this particular trip, I actually did several pages where I had a background already done, and then I drew an image and maybe added some black through stencils or something. But this one trip I took with Greg, and I'm in the bus and he's dealing with the passengers and everything, because that's what he does, drives bus. And when he's doing that and I get to go with him, it's kind of boring until he has downtime. So the whole time that he's working and doing his thing, or we're driving or whatever, I'm playing around in my art journal, and it turned out I got a lot of pages done that day. There was a lot of time where he was dealing with the customers and not me. So anyway, there's lots of shimmer in this one, but you can't really see it. It's way in the back. But I like this rose I drew. I thought that was pretty. Sometimes I have test pages where I just wanted to see what would happen. So I put down the modeling paste through a stencil, and then I went over the top of it with silks. And it didn't really give me the look I wanted. So I didn't end up using that for anything, but it's kind of cool, and it's really shimmery, and it's pretty, and has texture. Makes you want to touch it. And then, like, this is another one of those backgrounds that was done, and then I finished it on the bus. So same trip. Lots of fun doing this kind of thing because there's so much going on. And I just tried to focus on this stamp that was here, or this stenciled item that was here, or whatever. Yeah, and then just doodle it with Posca pens. And but there's flat and there's iridescent paint. So the way they mix together on this, on the page, is just so cool. Like that, the orange is a flat Dina Wakely paint, and then this blue turquoisey paint is Dina PBO's. So it's just really cool. I like that kind of stuff. There's a whole mixture of paints going on in this page. Okay, so like I said, sometimes they're upside down. So this is another one of those upside down moments. So just trying to test out some of the different materials and then turning that into a page. So that's really what happened here. Plus new stamps. Whenever new stamps come in, I want to play with those, of course. Okay, so I've seen this so many times on different videos where they do like the negative painting, like they leave the background as something peeking through, I guess. That's what I was trying to do here. So I basically negative painted this flower. So the background is showing through on these petals and a couple of these bubbles, but that's it. Everything else has been covered up. It's like you're looking through windows. It's kind of cool. And I just love the paints. They're just, oh, so much fun. Again, we're upside down. So this is Friends Are the Flowers in the Garden of Life. And on each of these stems are names of wonderful friends that I have been blessed by over the years. So you might recognize a few names. Not sure if it's going to focus in or not, but you might recognize some of those names. If your name is not there, it's probably because I hadn't met you yet. All right. And then, oh, see, and then I get confused because I don't know which way to go. Okay. It's upside down, so we go this way. Okay. Whoops, wrong one. Oh, another one of those backgrounds where everything just mixed just so. Yeah, I can't ruin it. Cannot touch this one. It's so wicked looking, isn't it? Okay, another, this is actually a brayer off page, so you can kind of see the swipey brayer page splats, and it's Dina PBO's, so you get all that yummy, delicious iridescence, and then you look at it like that, and it's just purple and orange, or purple and yellow, I mean. So those yellow is flat paint on top of that. And then, you know, stenciling and all. Oh, this, I love this page. I know, I told you, I warned you. So anyway, lots of fun. This was another one done on the bus, believe it or not. Another one done on the bus. So these were backgrounds that were done, and then I just added the black, anything black and white I added. And if that meant, you know, doodling circles and bringing them to the forefront and leaving everything else in the back, or if it meant making this look more like an orange wedge or an orange slice than the center of this flower. So there's a flower there, but you don't see the flower, you see the orange wedge. So I thought that was kind of fun. That made me realize just how valuable that stencil is, and I've used it many times because of that. But yeah, that's a neat one. It's kind of bold, and it's colors I don't normally like to use, so that's even more exciting. This is one of those backgrounds that's just waiting for that to happen. Do something with it. I might do like those drippy, circle-y drippy things with it and, you know, obscure everything else but leave like one of them open, or I don't know. So here's one of those times where I tried to do something like that, and I'm not sure that I like it, and I think it has to do with the color choice of the background. I didn't want to do white. And after I got this far, they kind of look like fishes to me, so then I thought I would make them fishes, and I just wasn't feeling it, so I quit. So this is where it's at. But there's some shimmer in some of that paint, and it was fun anyway. I like how the yellow is kind of streaming through. But anyway, another time where I was cleaning off a brush and I saw flowers when I did it, but there they sit. Another one done on that bus trip. It was the 4th of July weekend. This is my something red, white, and blue. And don't ask me. I don't know what it is. They're like cities floating in the sky or something. I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, it was fun. This was a spray off, dauber off spread thing, and the colors just make me want to hurl, so I'm probably never going to touch this page. Ever. Okay, this is super cool. Did this background long, long time ago, who even knows when. And then on the plane ride down to Arizona, I drew her face, and then several weeks after I got home, I painted her, and I love her. She's absolutely perfect. I love her eyes. Yeah, her feathered hair, and it has red. You can't really see it, but these are shimmery neons, or neons, no, neo colors. They're shimmered metallic in her hair. I want to do that to my hair. All right, more of the colors I can't stand. I got those dilution paints, and I was testing them out, and they go a little bit, goes a long way. So I have several pages that have these. I hate these colors. Absolutely hideous. I even tried, you know, adding my favorite stencil over it to make it more enjoyable. Like, she's staring at these martinis like, please get me the heck out of here. Yeah, anyway, another time when I wiped off a stencil and more of that ridiculous color combo. Ooh, I love this page. This is another one of those times where I just used my finger and went plick, 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 and it turned, you can even see the texture of it, some of these, hopefully. Oh dear God, you can't. Seriously, you can't see that. I don't know if you can see that right here. There's like little lines. It's like the texture of splotching it on there and pulling it off. It looks like the little grains of vein, whatever, through the flowers. And then I even have a fingerprint. There's even fingerprint right there. You can't see it. But. Some of them are sparkly. Some of them are shimmery. Like this, if you look at this one here, you'll see shimmer on the flat paint. Oh, so pretty. That was fun. I did this one when I was working at the store for my sister-in-law. Unfortunately, there was a lot of downtime at her store. That's too bad, because we want more sales, not downtime. But still. Ooh, I did a video on this. black gesso and Stabilo all pencils, and I think even Prismacolor or Crayola, maybe on. I'm not sure. Anyway, very pretty. Turned out really cool. Lots of cool. So there's a video for that. Stamped these guys because I thought I would color them when I was on a little road trip. Never did. Kind of boring anymore. Drew these guys. This was some kind of pencils that I have. They're like watercolor sticks or something. I don't know. It's the only time I ever really used them. Not sure I really liked them, to be honest with you. But it's kind of like a ghosty look to them, but they were hard to use. I think they'd need a different background than this kind of book. But anyway, that's interesting. Ooh, this I did when I was in Arizona. I had started on the plane, actually, and finished it while I was in Arizona, but during my trip last fall. I love this. The colors are just awesome. Okay, it's time to wrap it up real soon here. Okay, this is one of my most recent ones. Pan Pastels. This was a... I wanted to test out the pastel ground. And this was painted. The ground was painted into it. Mixed with water first and then painted all over. And then used Pan Pastels to create that sunset. There's a picture of Montana sky that somebody had taken. And I was totally inspired. And that's the end of my journaling walkthrough. Holy cow, that was a long one. I'm so sorry, you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Anyway, next week we'll be back to regularly scheduled programming of Kraaft It Live, and we've got 4 guests in February. You do not want to miss an episode, so head on over to Kraaft It Live. How do you get to that? Kraaftshaak.com/live, so that way you can register if you haven't done so already. But anyway, that's it, you guys. I love my art journals. See you later. Have a crafty day. Bye-bye.